Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan here, and I feel like lately I just have Metal Gear on my mind. That's kind of what I've been really talking about a lot in my channel. And so is everybody else, it seems like. You know, gaming journalists, I talk about Metal Gear. Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes just came out, so there's a bunch of rants, bunch of discussion surrounding that. Some of the IGN editors kind of discussing their favorite Metal Gear Solid moments. Game Trailers just did their top 10 boss fights in Metal Gear Solid franchise. And that's, I want to jump on the bandwagon on that, and that's what I'm going to do here in this video. This video is my top 10 favorite boss fights in the entire series, from what I've played. There are two Metal Gear games that I have not played myself. Those include Metal Gear Solid Ghost Babel, which is for the Game Boy Color. I played a little bit of it, but I've never fully beaten it. And Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, which came out pretty recently. I haven't played it myself, but I did watch an entire last playthrough of it. So I know the story, I know the gameplay, kind of. I know it, but I haven't played it myself. The boss fights in Revengeance look amazing. So I'm kind of disappointed that I can't, you know, add them here. But yeah, they look like pretty amazing boss fights. Maybe if I played Rising and I found all the boss fights to be amazing, maybe this list will be nothing but bosses from Revengeance. I don't know. So, kind of, let me explain the list that I have here before I get into it, because I think my list is going to be pretty upsetting to a lot of Metal Gear fans, just because I think it's going to be very different to, compared to most Metal Gear fans. I think that's great. You know, I think everyone has different lists, different unique preferences, and different experiences that they get out of the games. So my list really is kind of the emotional experience that I had with the gameplay. I'm not really so much focused on the characters themselves of the bosses, because then this would be a whole different list. Like, this really is focused more on the gameplay experience and the kind of the emotional attachment that I've come to have after the boss fight. That's where the ranking comes in. The character, you know, what kind of character the boss is, does have a kind of a factor to it, but it's not the overriding element to my list. I'm considering all things, and that's why the list is the way it is. One thing is very interesting to me as I was doing the list. None of the boss fights in Metal Gear Solid 2 makes it into my list. So it's kind of interesting to me that I consider the boss fights in Metal Gear Solid 2 to be the worst in the franchise. They're still really great, but I couldn't put them into this list because there's so many other great boss fights in the entire franchise. So I thought that was pretty interesting. If this list was top 11 favorite boss fights, so if I had to include one more, then yeah, there would be, I would have Solid the Snake as 11. When you fight him atop Arsenal Gear in New York City, and after crashing into Manhattan, that was pretty fun. I like that because, well, like, you're fighting Solid Snake personally this time, and also you're wielding a sword. Pretty much for the first time ever in Metal Gear Solid series, you know, you're wielding a sword and using that, and that's really fun. And Solid Snake has, like, this octopus thingy-majinkies that shoots missiles, rockets at you. Pretty fun boss fight. I think that boss fight in that game really stood out to me because of that kind of unique nature. And also the AI conversation that happens, you know, you speak with the two AIs of the Patriots right before you fight Solidus. So that's what makes it memorable. But unfortunately, that would have to be an honorable mention for me, because there's so many other great boss fights in the series. So let's get started. Number 10 for me is Big Boss. You fight Big Boss in Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake. Yeah, the old 2D game. I include this because it's, I don't know, to me it has a really great emotional value in not only like the experience itself, but like how you defeat Big Boss is interesting. Like, you know, you defeat him by making a makeshift flamethrower and you freaking burn him alive. He's chasing you. It's pretty intense. It's not an easy boss fight, you know. Well, actually, all of the boss fights in Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake are pretty tough. That game is that's a tough game. That's a really, really tough game. But you burn him alive. You know, there's a really great satisfactory feeling to that, because in Metal Gear 1, freaking the whole building blows up. And Big Boss survives. Like, this is a guy who survives his own base just being exploded, right? You blew up his base, he comes back in Metal Gear 2 like, oh yeah, I'm still alive, and I'm still doing things, you know? And there's still, like, plot twist that Big Boss is the mastermind behind in Metal Gear 2. So Metal Gear 2, you finally freaking burn him alive. It's just like, survive this, man. You can't possibly survive this. And, you know, all throughout the series, he's pretty much presumed dead. You know, Metal Gear Solid 1 begins with terrorists demanding the body of Big Boss. And, you know, that just goes to tell you, like, he's dead, you know? Like, there's no way he comes back from being burned alive. And there's great satisfaction to that. And it's you kind of... You know, Metal Gear Solid explains, you know, that Big Boss was the father, or, you know, kind of, so to speak, of Solid Snake. So there's that connection there that I really, really enjoyed. And that's why, for me, I had to include Big Boss, and that's why he's above Solid Snake, because there's that more of an emotional attachment there. Number 9, I would say, Psycho Mantis. Now, I know what you're thinking, like, whoa, Psycho Mantis is number 9? Why is he so low on the list? Because I feel like many Metal Gear fans, I would actually have him as number 1 most awesome boss fight. Kojima himself has said, like, you know, when I make Metal Gear games, I always try to one-up Psycho Mantis. That's why I think Screaming Mantis was the way it was portrayed in Metal Gear Solid 4 and whatnot. He wants to keep coming, and he also, like, the sorrow, he wants to keep trying these, like, new things, so that the boss fights are better than Psycho Mantis. Many would argue that he hasn't ever achieved that, you know, because Psycho Mantis has such a emotional impact on Metal Gear fans. For me, the impact is not that great. I think the way I explain it is because the first time I experienced Metal Gear Solid was not on PlayStation. I got the PC version. No, Metal Gear Solid Integral, the PC version, and I think that changes things. And I played it with on just using the keyboard. I didn't have a separate controller hooked up at the time, and the keyboard itself acts as is player 2 controller. That's how the game registers it. So I never really had a problem of being stuck on Psycho Mantis when I first encountered him. I thought it was pretty interesting that he can read the saves of my game, but on the PC, you know, it's not like it can do that. There's no memory card attached to it. So the impact of Psycho Mantis' fourth wall breaking element for me the first time wasn't that great. Now, I recognize that impact. When I played the PlayStation version of it, you know, I recognize that there's also a different way to beat Psycho Mantis. Second way, you don't have to change the controller. I don't know if this is a spoiler, but if you go back to play Metal Gear Solid, and you die, and you start over, and you keep dying, you can contact Colonel Campbell, and Campbell's like, oh, is your second controller perk messed up? And he's like, yeah. Oh, that's too bad. But there is a way to defeat Psycho Mantis without changing the controller port. And that's, it really has to do with the psyche of the Psycho Mantis. He's very egocentric, self-centered, but insecure about himself. So you'll notice there are statues of Psycho Mantis in that room. You shoot that, and that makes him vulnerable. And you shoot the statue, and then you can shoot Psycho Mantis using the first controller port. Pretty ingenious, right? There's two ways to defeat Psycho Mantis, and I always love that inventiveness about these boss fights in Metal Gear Solid games. But he's number 9 simply because without that fourth wall breaking element, I don't know, like, that boss fight is pretty simple. You know, you just kind of lay around, go in crouch mode, and you'll be invulnerable, you just run around and shoot. The boss fight without that fourth wall breaking element is not as great, and Psycho Mantis barely has any screen time in Metal Gear Solid 1. I had my friend watch me playing it, and my friend said, you know, he's never really experienced, you know, he's this is his first time, and he's heard about Psycho Mantis kind of before, and at the end of the day, he was just like, oh, that's really it? That's the only time he appears in the entire game, pretty much? You know, he has such a short amount of screen time in the game. He has such a huge impact among gamers, I understand, because of the way he breaks that fourth wall. But beyond that, the boss fight itself, when I replay the boss fight, so replayability also counts into factors into my reasoning here. When I replay that boss, it's just like I know how to beat him already, so that kind of surprise factor is gone. It's kind of like Screaming Man, Laughing Octopus in Metal Gear Solid 4. The first time you fight that boss, it's pretty exhilarating. Second time, like, it's really boring. You know, I get that feeling with Psycho Mantis. It's not a very replayable boss. And that's why, for me, Psycho Mantis is number 9. Now, this video is already 10 minutes long, so I'm going to cut short here and continue on with my list in the following videos. Hope you guys enjoyed. Give me some comments down below about what you think about number 10 and 9 choices so far. You know, you should make your own list of, you know, your favorite boss fights in the Metal Gear franchise and let me know. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in the next video. Cheers.